issue with our server motors, particularly that they had a limited radii. So, in order to adjust for this issue, we changed the ratio between our driver gear and our driven gear. In order for the pulley to bring down the radial chaos all the way down to our LED matrix and touch the fragile chaos that is in your below. Another addition to our sculpture that has been new since our last midterm was the addition of our humidifier and temperature detector. We replaced our oscillation reaction simply because it was too unsustainable to keep at equilibrium. So instead, our humidifier and temperature detector replace the area along the columns. These sensors represent the rationality of chaos in the face of all the hardships that we face. And they actually are part of the support columns that uphold our very sculpture and uphold our very city. And some people decide that they would rather seek entertainment from this chaos. They actually enjoy the discourse that is New York. And right now, we're going to introduce Abby, who will talk more about that element of our project.
By the way, from back here, I can hear everyone pretty well. That's okay. Eric. So, cool. Yeah.
I skipped the website part. Maybe I should have done that.
So I'm going to go down the exit through that way.
So, we should. Okay, so I think like I'm closer. Most people are going to be closer over here, so maybe we should have people waiting over there and people who are like going to exit this way. Because it's kind of weird, like going like.
Oh, that's true.
Like, from over there. I don't know, that's just my opinion.
Me. Your
time. Okay.
Alright. So, pretending that I'll be finished with the transition. Hi, my name is Amal Bukhari, and I'm here to represent the Forgotten Borough. Now, I realize that Staten Island probably isn't the first place you think of when you think NYC. But hear me out. As a native New Yorker, I appreciate the iconic sights of the city. But also, when I think of NYC, I think of home. I think of Staten Island. So, to represent this hidden gem of the city, our group decided to create a working model of the Staten Island Ferry. To create the ferry, we decided to make a small sculpture made out of molten aluminum, poured over water beads, to represent the water the ferry would go over. And for the ferry itself, it had to travel back and forth continuously to represent the continued cycle of travel that commuters experience, we decided to use a rack and pinion powered by a stepper motor. Some problems we ran into included the stepper motor being difficult to program and the rack and pinion having too much friction. So for the future, we would want to find a different way to mobilize the ferry and a more artistic, abstract way to represent the ferry to capture its essence in a more interesting way. Initially, we also planned to create a depiction of Radio City for our project. However, after speaking to School of Art professor William Villalongo and taking into account our size concerns, we decided to take Radio City out of the project, but we wanted to still include a musical element. So we decided to create a larger, interactive laser heart that passersby could come and make music with. However, we ran into problems when prototyping it because we couldn't program it properly. So for the future, we want to debug our code and create more working prototypes. Lastly, we wanted to create an interesting contrast between the Staten Island side of the shore the ferry was traveling from to the Manhattan side it was going to. To do this, we decided to create metal wind chimes. The Staten Island side would have more nature-themed visuals, so the bronze pieces represent sunbeams, and the silver pieces represent the modern industrialism of Manhattan. Looking forward, we want to include more found items for this part of the project, and we actually find Staten Island and Manhattan to provide an interesting visual contrast between the two places. Because after all, Staten Island is only a boat ride away from Manhattan, as Terry will show you with Team Staten Island.
Thank you. I'm not a native New Yorker. When I first arrived in New York, the first thing that caught my eye was the skyline. It was so awe-inspiring. With huge skyscrapers expanding across the entirety of Manhattan. Our group wanted to capture New York's skyline for all its wonders. To accomplish this, we decided to make three separate components, each representing an aspect of New York's skyline. The first component is the Geneva Complex. This consists of three buildings being rotated by a Geneva wheel, which is then powered by a complex system of gears. These buildings will constantly stay in motion, will have words on them, which will sometimes rotate themselves into coherent phrases. but most of the time it will spell out incoherent jumbles of words. With this, we wanted to capture the ever-changing nature of New York skyline, the fact that it never stands still and is always changing. With the words in the buildings, we wanted to demonstrate the fact that while New York might seem chaotic and incoherent, there exists an order amidst this chaos. The next component is the Black Eye Crane. This consists of a crane on top of a building being rotated by a stepper motor. The crane itself has a black light strip, as you can see there, on it, so it can illuminate the black light painted buildings when it rotates, as seen in the picture. This component emphasizes the changes New York goes through with the crane representing the construction around New York. And while the black light represents a city that never sleeps, with the city remaining bright and colorful even when at night. Our final component are the LED buildings. These consist of buildings made from acrylic, which will be illuminated by LED lights. With sensors that detect touch, the lights will change color depending on the tactile input from its viewers. This represents the vibrant colors of New York and how everywhere you look, nothing is the same color. It also represents the fact that New York is defined by people, by allowing the viewer to interact with the sculpture, but to demonstrate this fact. And while Manhattan's skyline is grand, we ultimately remember what will keep us here for 4 years, Cooper. Lewis will talk about how Cooper is part of the New York identity.
Hi, my name is Sungjin Song, and I'm the presenter for Infinity in You. In essence, our project is that unique people, unique experiences. So far, my classmates have given you 7 different answers to the questions that we're presented with. But before we end the presentation, I want to give you a slightly different view to the question. So when we are given the question, we start researching on New York City, its structures, its history, and we went to museums for inspiration. We all walked around our surroundings to find something that we can present. But we noticed that the more we learned about New York City, the more answers we were getting. And sometimes the answers conflicted with each other, but when we looked at each answer by itself, it all made sense. Rather than taking it as a failure to find the answer, we realized that that is the answer. Since people are unique, they all have different experiences in New York City, which means there can be infinite number of solutions to this problem. And in our project, we wanted to show the New York City itself. Next slide, please. But there was a problem because by looking at it from the side, you cannot see the whole New York City. So we were inspired by Inception, the bending of the city, to bend New York City into U-shape, so that people can see the whole aspect of New York City from one view. But another problem arose in that it's very hard to make a U-shape, because it's hard to curve everything out of a whole block. It's dangerous and it's risky, or it's hard to bend a wood. So we decided to make it like a Lego piece, as you see here. 2 components, when we combine them, it becomes a U-shape. And in the rectangle holes on the U-shape, we decided to put lights in there for the diorama effect. Next slide, please. For the diorama, we wanted to use dioramas to represent the surroundings of New York City, the neighborhoods of New York City, the buildings that you see every day, the sculptures. There's Cooper Union buildings, there's the cube that you see every day. So with this and the New York City, we wanted to basically make the small New York City in our sculpture. Next slide, please. So the part that we actually show the infinity in there, before, for a midterm, we wanted to make a train on Mobius Street. However, there was a problem with that, in that when the train has to go up the Mobius Street, because of the shape of the Mobius Street, there is a point where the train loses contact with the Mobius Street, and the train cannot go up the street. We were trying to solve that problem, but there was no definite solution to that problem that we could find. So using the design process, we found an alternate solution to this problem. So that's how we came up with the Infinity New York symbol. So when you're looking at from the front view, you see New York. However, when you change your view, when you change your angle, you see an infinity symbol. So this represents that the thing that you see every day, the appearance of it is not everything that you see. When you slightly change your view, the whole thing changes. Next slide, please. So we wanted to emphasize that our project is never ending. The ones that we have right now is not the complete project. This has to go on and on because New York is never ending. And on our website, there's a place where you can share your own experience with us so that we can get inspired by your experience in New York City. Please explore New York City by yourselves and share your opinions with us so that we can further develop our project. Thank you, and I hope you enjoy your New York experience.